Hello, this is Prash Talwalkar. Here are five facts that everyone should know about the mathematical constant pi. Fact number one, the definition. Pi is the ratio of the circumference of a circle to its diameter. That is, pi equals the circumference divided by the diameter. What's special is this is true for every single circle, whether the circle is very big or whether the circle is very small. Pi will always be the ratio of the circumference to the diameter for every single circle. Fact number two, pi is irrational. Pi is equal to approximately 3.14159265 and so on. The decimal form continues on forever, and it never repeats. The fraction 22 over 7 is accurate to two decimal places, and the fraction 355 over 113 is accurate to six decimal places. But because pi is irrational, there is no fraction a over b, where a and b are integers, that will be exactly equal to pi. Pi is also transcendental, which means pi will never be the root or the solution of a non-constant polynomial with integer coefficients. Fact number three, Archimedes estimated pi more than 2,000 years ago. Archimedes considered a circle which had a diameter of 1. The circumference of this circle will be equal to pi. So Archimedes thought he could estimate the circumference of the circle by considering drawing a hexagon inside of the circle. The perimeter of this hexagon will be clearly less than the circumference of the circle, which is pi. Archimedes also considered drawing a hexagon around the circle. Now the perimeter of this hexagon will be larger than the circumference of the circle, so we can have an upper bound for pi. Using trigonometry, Archimedes could calculate the perimeter of the hexagon and estimate pi. He then ingeniously doubled the number of sides and considered the same argument for a 12-gon. He doubled the number of sides again and considered the argument for a 24-gon. He could calculate these perimeters of the inscribed and circumscribed perimeters to get a lower bound and upper bound for pi. He got all the way to the 96-gon, in which he found that pi must be wedged between 223 over 71 and 22 over 7. This gave him an approximation that pi is about 3.14, which was very good and often practical. Fact number four, pi can be expressed in many infinite series. This is my favorite infinite series. Pi over 4 equals 1 minus 1/3 plus 1/5 minus 1/7 plus 1/9 and so on as the alternating sum of odd fractions. This is the Leibniz formula, which was also discovered by the Indian mathematician Madhava. Another formula is pi squared over 6 is equal to 1 over 1 squared plus 1 over 2 squared plus 1 over 3 squared and so on. This formula was found by Euler, and it's a beautiful relationship between the numbers and pi. There are also many complicated infinite series. This is one similar to one the Indian mathematician Ramanujan would have come up with. And these types of formulas are used in the Chudnovsky algorithm, which is how pi is determined algorithmically on computers. Fact 5. Pi comes up in probability. Here's a drawing of the normal curve or the bell curve, which you've seen in statistics class to describe many different data. The equation of the curve is e to the power of minus 1/2 x squared divided by the square root of 2 pi. So even in probability, pi is a very important constant, and it comes up. Consider Buffon's needle problem. Imagine randomly dropping a needle of length L on a floor where the lines are one unit apart. What's the probability the needle will intersect with one of the lines? The answer is 2 times the length of the needle divided by pi. So unexpectedly, pi comes up even in probability. I hope you liked this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can get my books listed on my website. Follow my blog, Mind Your Decisions. Follow Mind Your Decisions on Facebook and Google+. Catch me on @PreshTalwalker on Twitter, Instagram, and Tumblr. And you can support me on Patreon.